Welcome back. It's Bobby. It's Evening Side, and that was the Harbor House Community Calendar here on a very Halloweeny kind of day. This is, of course, one of my fave parts of the evening's programming, and that is the Homegrown segment with my cousin Chestar, who I can hear heavy breathing in the background in his zombie-like manner.
Happy Halloween to you, Kev.
Hey, buddy. Sorry, let me tweak your level. There you go. Cool. How you doing?
Good. You going out trick-or-treating tonight?
No, I'm working at the spook house. I was doing some lighting for our local haunted house, Man Hall, for those of you listening. It's on until the fireworks, and if people are interested, it is encouraged not to bring anyone below middle school, because it's very scary.
Ooh,
and little kids
I'm
might
shaking.
Not. Of course you are.
Well, I won't be out there. Trick-or-treating tonight. I've never been one to really dig sugar so much, even when I was a kid, you know? I would be the one kid that would fill a pillowcase and then share my candy with girls and boys that didn't get any.
That a boy, yeah, yeah.
But another question for you, have you gotten a good scare yet?
Have I gotten a good scare yet? Yes, yes, actually I did, just this morning. You got another one for me?
I wonder what that was.
Well, it has to do with large amounts of electricity and not doing your little bits of checklist in the morning before you handle all that. Anyway, it all ended well because I have a natural-born fear factor that makes me flinch anytime I'm uncertain, and it operates at the unconscious level.
Well, cuz, I'm glad you're still here.
Thanks, buddy. Me too.
I got a good scare last Wednesday when I went out to Fright Night at P&E. The haunted houses are great,
right?
And to really get the full experience, though, you got to be the first in your group, because elsewise the scare just doesn't have the same effect. First person gets the bejesus scared out of them, and then everyone behind them just laughs.
So you got to pick a good screamer to go first. Somebody who can really let it hang, yeah. We have an actress in Daddy's Girl that can do that. She can let go with a scream. I tell you what, it curdles milk and breaks windows. It's amazing. Really,
that'd be a high C note then. Wow.
Somewhere up there, way higher than this cowboy can get, that's for sure.
Well, I won't even try. Not even on the radio.
No,
right.
I like to talk down here in my socks. That's where I like to talk.
Well, today being Halloween and all, I figured why not a song with a theme that would go along. So today I'm bringing to the listeners the Headstones.
Ah, yes.
The Headstones are a Canadian hard rock band that began in the late 1980s in Kingston, Ontario, and were active until 2003, and subsequently reformed in 2011. The band is headed by frontman Hugh Dillon, who some may recognize from various films and his appearances in bands since the 80s. Now that they're back together again, they have two shows at the Commodore here in Vancouver on December 27th and 28th.
Ooh.
Yeah, I'd like to wish everyone a happy, safe Halloween, and here's a good taste of the Headstones for your Halloween with Cemetery off their album, Picture of Hell.
Picture of Hell on Evenside, CFSI-FM 107.9, Salt Spring Island Radio. Thanks, cuz. Have a good Halloween.
Happy Halloween!
cemetery, looking for love. Got there and my baby was buried, I had to dig her up. Went down to the cemetery, looking for love. Got there and my baby was buried, I had to dig her up. Went down to